In this example, we want to find the missing piece if g of x equals x squared plus 3. So they give us g of x here, and we want to find, and they give us the composition, f of g of x. So it's good to think of this as f of g of x. Okay, so we can kind of think of this g of x as the inner, and the f of x as the outer. Okay, so when we look at this here, it's one of these things, it kind of jumps out at you, right? So here's the g of x down here, right? You can kind of see it here, g of x. So what if we let f of x be, how about just 1 over x? 1 over x, right? Then f of g of x, f of g of x, aka f composed with g of x, well, now we're putting in all of g of x into the x down here, so that's 1 over x squared plus 3. That does the trick, so let's just stick with this f of x here as the answer. All right, f of x equals 1 over x. So that one kind of jumps out at you. For b, we have f of g of x equals x to the 4th plus 6x squared plus 20. That one's a little more complicated. But there's a method here. Let's look at just this bit here. We have x to the 4th plus 6x squared. I'm looking for an x squared plus 3. We're still using the same g of x, right? G of x is going to be that. Okay, so I'm not seeing that in here. But let's take a look here. If we use completing the square, let's use complete the square on this first bit. So let's just take x to the 4th plus 6x squared, and I'm going to move this 20 off to the side. Okay, now I'm going to complete the square here, so I'm going to take the b term, or this middle term here, divide by 2, and square it. Okay, so that's equal to what? 6 divided by 2 is 3, squared is 9. So I'm going to go plus 9 here, and then minus 9 there. Okay, so what have I done? Well, now this becomes x squared plus 3 quantity squared. So I completed the square on this part here plus 11. This part right here just became 11. Negative 9 plus 20. Okay, but look, this is our g of x. So we're asking ourselves, what can we plug g of x into to get this result? So let's just look at this bit here. So what if we let f of x be, x squared plus 11. That'll do it. Because when I plug in g of x here, let's just test it. Test it out just to be certain. F of g of x is, okay, so we're plugging in all of g of x into x here. So we have x squared plus 3 quantity squared plus 11. Okay, so expand this out. We get x to the 4th plus 6x squared plus 9 plus 11 is still hanging out there, which is indeed x to the 4th plus 6x squared plus 20. Check, it works. So it's a little hard to arrive at that, but don't ever underestimate the power of completing the square. It can get you to some pretty interesting places.